Good evening, everyone. We are going to start with a new chapter, that is AM and FM detectors. In last chapter, we have studied the different kinds of parameters, that is different kinds of parameters of the receivers like sensitivity, selectivity, fidelity, image frequency, tracking, double spotting. Likewise, we have seen all these parameters with respect to the transmission of the information signals. Now, as we know, information signals can be like information signals will be analog signals, digital signals, or we can also transmit computer information or computer datas. So what we are in respect to these points, what we are doing at the time of modulation is that first this information signal is converted into a type of electrical signals, and this electrical signals is been transmitted to the communication channel. So this is nothing but a communication channel. This is the input and this is the output block. So this information signal is been applied to the inputs block, then it is converted and then it is converted into the electrical signals, which has been applied or which has been given as an input the communication channel, and through this communication channel we are going to take the signal to the output block. Now here the output block is nothing but we are going to receive the main electrical converted electrical signal at the output side. Now with respect to this output, we are going to convert this output to the output transformer. So this transformer is going to give us the output of main information signal which has been transmitted. So to convert this main information signal, what is required is the detector side, or this information is given to the detector, that is nothing but the receiver side. So to get the whole procedure from the main information signal to the detector side, we are going to have the two types, that is envelope detector and the second one is practical detector. So we know for this main information, or to convert this main information into the detector side, what we are expecting is that the main analog signal or the main information signal, that is nothing but which is in converted of AF signal, it is in the main envelope. So this envelope is given to the demodulator or to the detector side, and in return we are going to get this converted into the main message signal. So this conversion of main message signal is nothing but done by the block called as demodulator, or it has been done with the help of detector. So this block, which is consisting of demodulator or detector, is nothing but first one we are going to get as an envelope detector, and second one we are going to see is the practical detector. So let us see in detail about the envelope detectors. So this envelope detector is nothing but we can call it as a diode detector. Now this diode detector is nothing but what we can see in this diagram is we are going to place a diode detector over here, where the main information signal is applied, and at the receiver we have been detected with a message signal. So what is this diode detector, or what do you mean by envelope detector, is nothing but the envelope detector is a simple and very efficient device which is suitable for the detection of a narrow band AM signals. So as we know, for the transmission of AM signals or with the transmission of the RF signals, there are two bandwidths required. First one is the narrow bandwidth and second one is the wide bandwidth. So with respect to the name itself, that is narrow band and wide band, with respect to these two informations, the detector has been replaced. So if we need to convert this narrow band signals at the detector side, we are going to use a simple diode detector. A narrow band AM wave is the one in which the carrier frequency, that is nothing but the FC, is much higher as compared to that of the bandwidth of the modulating signal. We know while the transmission or with this AM signal or FM signal, there are two information signals required. One is first one, the carrier signal, and second one is the modulating signal. So this carrier signal FC is always greater than this modulating signal. So as we know that the envelope detector produces an output signal that is approximately follows the envelope of an AM signal. As we know, whatever the input signal you are going to apply, it has been going to follow this main shape, that is nothing but the AF signals. So here in the circuit diagram, you can see that the main information signal, which is nothing but the AF signal, is applied as the input signal, and at the detector, you are going to get back into the main original signal. So let us see the operation of this envelope detector. The standard AM wave, this is nothing but this AM wave, the AM signal is been applied as an input to the detector. As output is in the form of whole cycle, that is positive as well as negative cycle. For the positive cycle, this diode is going to get, in half positive cycle of the input signal, the diode detector, it will be in a forward bias condition. And as this it is in a forward bias condition, till then the capacitor C, which is placed over here, will be charged till the input signal. So as the capacitor is charged to the input signal, it will be charged, the filter capacitor C connected across the load resistance R to the almost to the peak input voltage. Therefore, this C is the small capacitor and R is a large resistance. So together R and C will form an RC filter. As a capacitor charges to the peak value, the diode stops conducting and the capacitor will discharge through this resistor R. In the next positive cycle, again this diode is going to conduct in a forward bias condition. But when it is going to charge is when first this capacitor has to discharge. The discharging process continues until the next positive cycle. Now here you can see the envelope detector diagram where this positive peaks. Here the diode is going to conduct and while discharging the capacitor is discharging till the next positive peak. Likewise, whole envelope it has been detected. So here you can see at the this side the diode is on and while at the discharging the diode is going to get off, and that off is nothing but this capacitor C is going to get discharged through this resistor R. In this way the whole procedure is going to repeat with the help of this diode detector. It is as simple as that of the envelope detector. Second, we are going to see is the practical diode detector. With compared to that of the simple diode detector, now we are going to see the practical diode detector. The circuit diagram is as shown in this of the practical diode detector. In this practical diode detector, as the direction of the diode has been reversed in the negative envelope, which will be demodulated. As we have seen in this simple diode detector, the diode is connected in a forward bias condition, that is nothing but it is connected in the positive half cycle. In this practical diode detector, this diode is converted to the negative cycle so that the negative cycle is first going to get demodulated. Due to this negative AGC, voltage will be developed across R1 and R2. Due to this, as the diode has been connected at the negative side, this AGC output will be generated. That is, negative AGC will be generated. So, resistance R and therefore the resistance R1 and R2 is nothing but provided a series DC path for the diode current to the ground. That is, discharging for the capacitors. So, here also we can see in this diagram is that the capacitor R1 and C1 is nothing but going to form an LPF, that is nothing but low pass filter, which is used to remove the ripple factors which is produced at the DC components. With respect to this, we are also going to see that capacitor C3 and resistor R3 is also going to form an LPF, which is used to remove the AF component at the demodulator side. So with respect to that, also we are going to see that this capacitor C2, which is going to act as a coupling capacitor and which is present at the diode D2, that is nothing but here the diode it is formed for output from reaching to the R4, that is at the volume potential, that of the volume control. To reach this signal directly to the R4, we are going to use the coupling capacitor C2. So the capacitor C2 is a coupling capacitor which prevents the diode DC output from reaching to the volume control potentiometer R4. Hence, across the R4, we are going to get the demodulated signal with a zero DC shift. This signal is then applied to the AF amplifier. The R3 and C3, as I told you earlier, the R3 and C3 is a combination which forms a low pass filter, and its function is to remove the AF components from the demodulator's output. As we know, the output of DC is nothing but only applied this DC components we want, and we want to block the AF components. So to block this components, AF components, we are going to arrange this filter, that is R3 and C3, which is going to act as a low pass filter. So this filter will allow only the DC components to pass through this AGC voltage. The AGC voltage is then applied to this RF and IF amplifiers to control their gain automatically. As we know, as we have seen in the last chapter, what that is AGC, that is automatic gain control. And to control that gain, the output of this AGC is then applied to the blocks for an RF and IF stages. Such a practical diode detector circuit is used in the domestic radio receivers, and this DC voltage produced at the detector output is proportional to the signal strength, stronger than the AM signal, higher than that of the AGC voltage. That means these two practical diode detector and as well as the simple diode detector, these two types we are going to use only for the domestic purpose. And hence, the next points, that is with respect to FM detector, that is slope detector, phase discriminator and radio detectors, are the types of FM detectors. So now, for now, we have seen these two, which is the types of